Bokuben is an amazing manga, and one of the best harem manga in my opinion. The art style is amazing, and the story is actually amazing, which is hard to find in a harem story, and the characters of course are awesome, but unlike with most harem manga, where there's a definitive best girl, in Bokuben, all of the girls are best girl in their own way. And that is what makes Bokuben so awesome in the first place, because it isn't about writing these characters to fall in love with our protagonist. The girls all have unique and interesting personalities that get explored in more detail, as we start to learn about why each of the girls has fallen in love with the protagonist. And another thing about this manga is so good, unlike most harem manga, is that the protagonist isn't just some self-insert loser. Naruyuki feels like a real dude who is just trying to help his friend study and helping his family by trying to get a good job. Honestly, if I had to say what makes Bokuben so different from most harem manga, I would say it's the complexity of the characters. They're all written in a way where even if your personal best girl didn't win in the end, you would still be satisfied because all the girls felt like they deserved to win in the end, and that is so freaking amazing. Now, from here on out will be spoilers, so if you wanted to know my thoughts, I'd say go ahead and watch the anime if you really like the story, then go ahead and continue with the manga, because if you do that, I promise you won't be disappointed. So, the problem I have with Bokuben is how the ending felt like a cop-out in my opinion. Instead of just picking one definitive winner of the harem, the mangaka decided to do all the different routes, which is fine if he didn't change things in the story that had already happened to fit the narrative of the route at hand. The best and most fluid route of the girls is definitely Erika's route, and that might be because her route was first, but comparatively to the other girls, the mangaka didn't have to change certain plot points to fit the narrative of the route we are on. It felt most complete as well, and Erika isn't even my personal best girl, but her route just felt the most fluid and felt like it had the best ending on top of that. But then the last chapter hits me with a curveball and makes it so that none of the routes are real, and it all just turns into a weird memories of each of the girls, and honestly, that one chapter saved the ending in my opinion, because before it felt like a cop-out where the mangaka couldn't pick a winner amongst the girls, so he just wrote every ending, but now it ended where we can pick our own winner, and that is a lot better, because although it's a cop-out, it's better cop-out than just letting every girl win because of the fans. But the ending didn't turn me off in the series, far from it. Bokuben is still a masterpiece, and I think any lover of the harem genre should absolutely read it because it is amazing. Bokuben has absolutely amazing characters. Each and every one of the girls is best girl, and hell, even the side characters are all well written and interesting. The characters in Bokuben are what make it so good. They're lively, interesting, funny, and make for great moments. Each of the characters is unique, and each of the characters has a whole arc dedicated to them to help flesh out the characters, and each and every one of their arcs is amazing and help to get you to fall in love with the characters of Bokuben. Furuhashi is a great character, and throughout the manga, almost all the way to the end, she shows her personality by pushing away her own feelings for her friends. She doesn't want to hurt her friends, she wants to stay friends forever with all of them, but eventually she explodes and she can't keep them hidden any longer. Furuhashi is a girl who comes from a rich background who doesn't act arrogant or like she is better than anyone. It's actually quite the opposite. Furuhashi is very humble and would rather see other people happy. Yeah, she can be selfish at times, like how although she has a serious talent for all things literature, she would rather study astronomy and learn more about the stars because that is what she loves the most. Furuhashi is a character who, over time, you start rooting for more and more because of how many struggles she has gone through, not just before the story, but also during the story, and that is what makes her character so awesome. Ogata was originally my personal best girl, and she stayed that way for a while. She is still one of my favorite girls in Bokuben, and that is in large part due to her personality. She is very stereotypically nerdy and very good at math, and like Furuhashi, she doesn't want to use her talents because it is not something she's interested in. Instead, she would rather study literature so she can one day make her own board game, but also so she can one day understand the feelings of her grandmother and those around her, and I love that about Ogata because I'm not very good with other people's emotions, or hell, even my own emotions, and so to me, she's a very relatable character. Her strength to keep on pushing through even when everyone told her to stop is also very commendable, because even Furuhashi at one point was almost ready to just give up and study literature, but it was Ogata who pushed to continue to follow her dreams, and I absolutely love that about her character. Erika, although not my personal best girl, is the one I was rooting for the most throughout the series. She is the childhood friend of our protagonist, and the one who has been in love with him the longest, plus the dynamic between the two characters is cute. The thing that I love the most about Erika is she's a very talented swimmer, but she doesn't let that define her. She still looks to do more with her life, and she ends up studying and learning English to a very efficient degree by the end of the series, which is awesome, plus the fact that Erika is a very good friend. She is always ready to hang out and have fun, and she's very bubbly and almost seems open, but isn't actually. Erika is a great character, an amazing friend, and the girl with the best written route in the series by far. Mafuyu, when first introduced, comes off as a bit of a bitch, but as time goes on, we start to learn more about her character. We come to realize that the way she treated Furuhashi and Ogata was her way of showing that she cared about them. Mafuyu lives a life of a lot of regrets, and she doesn't like to see people waste their talents on silly dreams, so she tried to get Furuhashi and Ogata to stop being foolish. Mafuyu is also a character that catches you off guard when we first see her. Not in school, because you see this very stern and serious woman become a slob and super unrefined, and it actually humanizes her character, because now she isn't just some super strict teacher, now she is a teacher who is strict because because she cares and doesn't want her students to end up living a life of regrets, and that is one of the big reasons why I love her character. Kominami, my personal best girl, is a very awesome character. When we first see her, she is studying in a cram school to try to become a doctor, and at first I see that as something cool, but when I learn her reasoning for wanting to become a doctor, I love it even more, because Kominami is a very selfless person who wants to preserve her dad's clinic because she loves to see the smiling faces of her patients, and that is awesome. But another thing I love about her character is the fact that she is very hardworking. The first time you see her in the maid cafe, you're like, okay, so this is just going to be some jokey fan service, and it is, but it's also used as a way to show you that Kominami is a very hardworking person and will do anything, even something super embarrassing like being a maid, just to make her dream come true, and I absolutely love that about her character. The way the manga looks in both art style and paneling is great. The art style is so good, each of the characters looks so good. The anime didn't do the art justice. Like, the anime looks fine for what it is, but the manga looks actually amazing. Like, look at some of these panels, like, they seriously look amazing. The paneling in this manga as well also look absolutely amazing. The way that the mangaka was able to play off the jokes of the character moment so well with just the right paneling is awesome, and that is a big reason why I like Bokuben. Overall, Bokuben is one of my favorite harem manga because there's no definitive best girl. Like, for me, Kominami was best girl, but I actually wanted Uruka to win in the end because I felt like her interactions with the protagonist were the best. But overall, Bokuben knows exactly what it is, and it doesn't try to be more than that. But it does push what it is to its absolute limit, making it an amazing rom-com manga where the story is actually amazing and the characters grow and change and become better people than they were at the start of the story. And that is my absolute favorite thing about Bokuben. It is seriously amazing.